big difference. We have these three different with other ways of good technique, and then the finish grip, where the middle finger is behind the court. This time it's probably the most common grip. Jan Železný used, Tomáš Röhler used, Neeraj used it. So many of the top thrower used this. But it's a personal thing. Everybody should find the best way for himself. I like to talk about key positions of the javelin throw. And here it's a training throw from Jan Železný in South Africa in Potchefstroom. And one in the first picture, in the first picture, you see his sideways position. The arm could be a little bit higher than the javelin, the shoulder axe, and the hip axe pretty much parallel. But you see that he is active from pulling with the left leg into the cross step, impulse step. The shoulder axe, hip axe showing to this time in throwing position. And that's continue until he is landing with the right after the cross step. For example, his foot position. It's about 45 to 60 degrees to the throwing direction. Many athletes coming to me, also Anu, for example, started before with foot straight in throwing direction. That means that the hip is turning forward, open. Yeah, it can't stay, the axe can't stay in throwing direction, which destroy a lot of impulse we get from the right foot and from the right hip. On the picture four, you see also we have marked the parallelität. It's almost perfect from the hip axe, shoulder axe, and javelin, which is also important. I will show you later what happened if it's not like this. On the picture five, you see Jan, it's pushing from right foot into his knee, which is going horizontal forward. It's not get straight and push him over his left leg. It goes horizontal into the left block. And he is building a nice C position, means a bow position with his, from his right foot over the knee, hip, shoulder, into the arm. And the arm could probably a little bit higher, but it's also a little bit personal style. It can have also influence on stress on elbow. We'll see later with other athletes. On the picture 6 and 7, you see how stable the left block is. That's also very important. We have to get the speed from the right side into a stable block to accelerate the javelin, to have a great anchor point of the body to pull on the javelin and be able to accelerate and get a high release speed. So here we have some other positions. Here you see how active, you see really the activity and how he goes into the cross step. Yeah? It's pulling from left side and swinging from the right side. But always with the hip and shoulder axe back, yeah, sideways to the throwing direction. Landing, or just before landing, after cross step, you see leaning back with the upper body, very important. Many athletes, young athletes, try to throw only hard with the upper body, but the throw build up from the ground, from the feet, from speed, with activity of the legs, and for a good block and bow tension, we have to be first back with our upper body. Also to have a long acceleration pull on the javelin. Upper body leaning back 20 to 30 degrees. So body mass point should be over or even light behind the right landing leg. And here you see also again these 45 to 60 degree foot position. Yeah. Start to move into the block and still has this 45 degrees foot position. The hip shows still in throwing direction. Yeah, then pull step, it's a link between run up and throw. Yeah. And the run-up, it's very important, and many throwers are fast, but also many throwers losing speed at the impulse step. And impulse step has a name from giving an impulse, so increasing speed. And Jan Železný was a master of it. Yeah, we had in Halle a big throwing meeting every year, and in some of his last years, I think it was in 2004, they measured the speed during his run-up and compared to other throwers there. And he was the only one who increased his speed during the impulse step. All other losing speed, only concentrate on throwing hard. But he's his best weapon was his legs and how fast he built up his body position and his bow position. Yeah, keep body behind center of gravity. That's I told you already. Here is Jan and demonstrate at the Kuortane World Javelin Conference a few years ago how the throw build up from the right foot. Setting sideways, probably a little bit too much than we think it's good. So 45, 60 degrees, and then pushing from the foot into the knee against the strong left block. And during the whole time, you see how stable and close his shoulder is. His left shoulder from picture one to picture two, even his right foot pushed forward, but the shoulder goes inwards to close the left side to get a better block and get from light rotation movement in a straight linear throw. If you move your left shoulder too early backwards or downwards, like many other throwers are doing, you get more rotation into the block and not work direct against left. Here's marked how the foot is moving and the on the picture two in which direction the power line goes. The push goes horizontal into the knee and then into the hip to build up a big bow tension. Okay. Here you see me on top demonstrate the using of forearm and hand with a handball and down this Cassie Mitchell. You see also bending the arm have a good bow tension in the shoulder and whipping the throw. Some very or the most parameters which influence distance of throw with ball or javelin is the release velocity by magnitude and direction. Yeah? Release velocity has a most influence, but only if it's in the right or in the optimal direction. That means release angle and release angle for a ball. It's optimal between 45 and 35 and 40 degrees, depending of the implement and sure also on wind conditions. If you had headwind, you have to throw lower with tailwind a bit higher. For the javelin, it's a little bit lower. We think that's between 32 with headwind and up to 40 degrees with no wind or tailwind. Then we have other parameter is the angle of attack. You see it from the side. It has to be as close as possible to zero. So the throwing direction and the actually release angle between this, it's called angle of attack, and that should be, if possible, zero. 0 degrees was Jan Železný's world record throw. 0 degrees was from Barbara Spotakova, the world record. So that's small as possible. The angle of jaw, you see when you look from the back, that's where the javelin throws into, and the actually yeah, where the javelin shows into and the actually throwing direction where he is moving. I have also some not so good example, and you will see here very clearly the meaning of these both angles. Here's a throw from Johannes Vetter in Potchefstroom, 91 meter 22. If you remember before the position from Jan Železný, if you see the first picture, Johannes goes direct with the upper body into the cross step and is pretty open. The foot shows almost in, the right foot shows almost in throwing direction. The hip is open, and he is not leaning 1 centimeter back. Very upper body oriented thrower. you would say, yeah, but he throws up 91 meter or even further in Lucerne, 2018, but no, 17. But I think he has good throw much further if he had a better technique. On the picture, two upright, picture three, need way too long to come down with the left block leg. And in this time, the upper body is already in front and very open. Left shoulder, left arm, it's open. And so you get a bow tension, but pretty much without to involve his hip, it's only his shoulder. And you see also on this picture five that it means also a lot of stress for the shoulder and elbow because of his upper body position so much in front. His arm is compared to this way too low. And you see on the picture six and seven where the throw is going to, yeah, way too high. And you see also how big or strong the bend on the javelin is. That's also a very clear sign that the angle of attack, it's way too high, and you lose a lot of speed, yeah, which he can't get into the javelin. Here we have a not so good throw, but probably a bit similar to the throw in Potter's room, if we would see the throw in Potter's room from the backside. With his upper body, he often move to the left side. The power goes not into the javelin. It goes, like I marked with red, in a totally different direction. He is not the only one. I'll show you later also one Indian athlete who moved way too much to left. We have to concentrate that all the power we have goes linear into the javelin. And here it's an example from a bad angle of jaw. It's about 12 degrees. It's a little bit difficult to measure very correct. I think could be even a little bit bigger. Angle of jaw should also be small as possible to not lose speed on the and power into the javelin. Here we have a throw from Torkelsen from Oslo. You can look and see how linear he is going. Yeah, straight forward against the block and into the throw.
Tämän kisan kärjessä, mutta onko kauan, sillä nyt heittoon vuoroon tulee Andreas Torkildsen, Norjan tänä kaudella. Tällä kaudella heittänyt Norjan edetykseen 93, ja sitten lähti Torkildsenin veto. Ja hän skaartaa pitkälle, ja nyt menee yli 90 metriä. Siinä tuli tämän kisan johtoheitto Andreas Torkildsen kotiyleisönsä edessä. Räppäsee menemään, hän oli hirveässä kunnossa. Täällä alkaa heti jytä soimaan. Ja porukka innostuu aivan tosissaan.
Yeah, you see here that he is running straight, and also after the throw, he is still moving straight over the block in throwing direction. He is looking, watching the whole time the javelin. Yeah, that's very important. That means your head is in the right position. So as your body, yeah, special upper body. We will see later if you throw a style like Neeraj with throwing or jumping behind the or diving behind the javelin. That's a little bit similar. Different. Sorry. Here we have other very good throw from Thomas Röhler, and similar, yeah, all the run up straight over the block, straight, and watching behind the whole time. He has a javelin in his view. And if you do this, first you can build a good bow tension, but also very good block against left hip, left shoulder, which gives a big impulse into the throw. And not moving to the left means also not have a big angle of jaw and throwing direct in the middle of the sector. Yeah. If you watch it again. And you see also the quality of the whole throw. The javelin lands quite flat for the new model, yeah, compared with other throwers. Same as here, another example. Jan is, Jan is moving or diving behind, but still straight. Yeah? If you watch him go over the block, he's not moving a little bit to the side, direct, straight into throwing direction. Have a look. And even with diving, he watched the javelin the whole time. Here we have Neeraj at the Asian Games. Yeah, he's not watching. Yeah, he's moving to the to the left side and then even turn his back to the throw. It's you think it's cool, but it's destroy a little bit his block, left block, and he has two big angle of attack and angle of jaw, and the javelin it's landing almost on the left sector side. Yeah. You can also see the different of how the javelin flies and blend. Yeah, it's far away from optimal flying. The modern javelins, they can fly these days very good if you throw them, fly, give them a chance to fly. Not only power and upper body. We have to get better there. His throw from this year in Potter's room, you see on the picture one, landing after the cross step, impulse step, it's okay with probably 30 degrees of foot position to the throwing direction. That's okay, but a little bit upright, he should be a little bit more leaning back with his upper body and a little bit down, like a slightly sitting position. So he has not to drop after landing with his body down. Things with the left hip and left knee down. That's at the end on the picture five on the bottom. He is getting a little bit stronger at the end, but yeah, he should be strong the whole time. Here we have pictures areas from the World Record from Chelesny. Compare his block with Neeraj. Yeah? First, this landing position, the picture three on the top, landing right, and his body it's sideways and leaning back, and then working against a very strong left block. You see even how the energy against the foot, the left foot. The left knee not bent, Yeah, it's in hyper extend, and the left hip also not get really weak. It's strong into the block. Yeah, that was the main things for me, the important part, how I see the technique from javelin throwers. And you should also be aware that the main focus should be on being sideways. If it's Anu, Rani, or Rohit, when they came to me, they was pretty much frontal with the foot, and also with the right hip and the right shoulder. And now we have to work back on sideways, and that needs time, and often it's very, very difficult to change habits. You learn first wrong to change. Sometimes I spoke with other coaches. Some athletes never be able to change. So it's very important that you do it right on the first place. Yeah? And with young athletes, you can also introduce this sideways technique into made ball throws. Made ball throws like short put, yeah, with light made balls, only as technique learning, rhythm learning, with impulse step, with one impulse or two impulse, leaning back, and using the right hip. The throw build up from the bottom, foot, knee, hip, shoulder, arm. That's very important to know. And often we make or see often the mistake that special with young athletes, they only be concentrate on upper body. Yeah, upper body, and they like to apply force on the implement, but then they destroy the fundamentals. That was the last bit to the technique. Here are some strength exercise for the shoulder girdle. Very important to start early with these exercises. In Germany, they had a study with overhead sports like volleyball and javelin thrower, and 70% of I think 14, 15 years old athlete had already shoulder problems. So they started a program with them to strengthen the shoulder. Special, we see often the mistake that the backside of the shoulder will not get not enough exercises and not strong enough. So very important to strengthen the external rotators. And the rhomboids and the scapular stability. I don't like to get to every single exercise. Make a picture, or you get the presentation later. Here also some other exercises you can play around with your athletes, but very important is to strengthen the back of the shoulder. That's the accelerators, and these muscles very important to stabilize the shoulder, and the biggest stress on the shoulder, it's doing the deceleration. And for that, you have to be prepared. And not only after you get injured, you can prevent injuries with exercise like these. One important shoulder stretch for javelin throwers is a sleeper stretch. You can do it like this girl here by yourself or by a coach. Important is if you do it with a supporting person that you also stabilize your shoulder. Stretch and work on improvement. It should be weekly, at least twice, maybe three times a week. That earlier you start, the better you stay on this. We have here also in the camp with few athletes problems with these exercises, or with the shoulder and with the flexibility of the shoulder. And after we started these, it's improving very good. Stretch for external rotators, you can do it with the hand, or easier is it with a towel or a rubber band, or then some few words to the training of javelin throwers. Quite a lot athletes told me when I started here to work with them, oh coach, I never did jumps, single leg jumps, hops, or we never did something for coordination or gymnastic. And so it's very important that you work as athlete, or if you're a coach with your athlete, on to build up a javelin thrower who develop like a multi-event athlete. A lot of athletes came from other sports like handball, but also quite few are good in decathlon. Just a few months ago, Janis Luzes died, and he was one of the best javelin thrower the world had. And he came from decathlon. He did just under 8,000 points. So important it's for athletes from 14 to 18, good endurance can be swimming, biking, running. I learned also here that athletes, even they can throw almost 90 meters, they have problems with swimming. That should be basics. You should be well coordinated. Yeah, learn different games, volleyball, basketball. Basketball here in India, nobody of my athletes knows rules or know how to play basketball. Yeah. So, very good. It's also badminton for javelin throwers. Gymnastic, handstand walking, cartwheels, other gymnastic exercises, saltos, or we used or introduced slack lines to using slack line to our athletes. Will improve your coordination, will improve the way you learn things, and will help you with learning and doing technique changes. You should also be able to do other throwing events like shot put, discus throw. Many different kind of medicine ball throws. One arm, two arms, overhead in laying position on the Swiss ball. And very important is running, speed work. My athletes told me also that they did runs regular, but not really sprinting. Not trying to be as fast as possible or increasing speed. It's very important. Jumps, high jump, long jump. If you learn these techniques, you will help also your throwing technique. Hurdle, running, jumping. And surely also throwing different implements, and even we in special phases of our preparation, when we work on speed work, we using light javelins. So Schiffball or Neeraj throwing also 600 gram javelins. It's very important to increase the release speed and be able to be fast, and will help also on learning how to throw. if you be able to switch between 800 gram and 700 and 600 gram direct after each other, and you be able to let them fly very nicely, then you have good control over your javelin and good feeling for javelin. And that's very important for all javelin throw. We also throw with very light implements for overspeed, for example, with golf balls. You should do it also in your age and try to throw as far as possible. Some of our athletes throwing about 125 meters, and I think normally should be also possible to throw 150 meters. That's important, the speed, release speed. The faster you are in with a light implement, the faster you can be on a javelin later with good technique, surely. Yeah, when you start, all things are difficult. Yeah, before they are getting easy. That's, you should know. Practice, practice, practice. And surely understanding what you're doing. Not only train harder, use your head and understand your event. Thank you. Here another throw from Mirage again for the end. Yeah, one word to this last throw from Mirage. If he hit it, let it fly better, he would be able to throw 4 or 5 meters more. That much different make the fact to hit javelin perfect. Yeah, thank you. Stop sharing.
Thank you very much, sir. Now, let us move to question answer. The first question, few throwaways fall after the release covering more distance. Is it disadvantage?
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Yes.
I'm not really a fan of this. Only few throwers doing it right. Neeraj is close to it if it's moving more straight. I had also before another athlete, Qingyang Zhao from China. He did it also very good and was an advantage for him. For some other athletes, looks often as disadvantage because they are not blocking first. They only jumping into without a block, so they lose a lot of energy and impulse from the block.
Okay. Can I move to next question? What are drills to develop the throwing technique? What are drills to develop in the throwing technique?
Yeah, saw in my presentation, important is to the technique and then work step for step on this point. For example, cross steps into the sideways position without throwing. Or even first put your athletes in this position, yeah, with foot sideways, with the most of the or 80% of the body weight on his right leg, being sideways with the shoulder axe. Similar to the position I showed the presentation from about Jan Železný, the fundamentals. And it's a big field to talk about this, slow to fast. So you should start with standing in this position, then with walking in this position, then jumping in this position, all without throwing, yeah? And then moving from one cross step into second cross step. You have to know that it's very important that you take your time with this technique work, and do it again and again. And quality, it's very important. If I do it wrong, yeah, then I learn also a mistake. Yeah, so don't push your athlete or push as athlete yourself too much and look only for results. Results are important, but if you learn the technique right, results will coming also.
Yes, the next question. Please do explain about your statement. That is, the statement is the release angle depend on the implement and the direction of wind.
Yeah, if you have headwind, yeah, and you throw with a too high release angle, yeah, the javelin will rise and land quite steep. Yeah? It's more important to let the javelin float off on the air. Yeah? And that's not possible if the release angle is too high with headwind. If you have tailwind, you should throw a little bit higher because the tailwind could also push the javelin a little bit earlier down. It's important that the athlete know these things, but very important is also that athletes and also coaches learn it in training, that they're not looking only for results, for example, and but more on quality of flying of the javelin. In Germany, the biomechanic, they give even numbers out for the quality of flying of javelins or discos. And that you need to learn as javelin thrower, learn as coach, how important the quality of flying is makes big difference. And you can learn it doing training.
Okay, fine. Next question. Elbow and shoulder injuries are common in javelin throw. Can you give us some precautionary exercise to develop?
Yeah, first, what I said with strengthen the shoulder, the rotator cuff is very important, the muscle around to strengthen often the mistakes that everybody has strengthen is front, front muscle, pec, they are very strong, but the back of the shoulder, they are very weak. When I started with my former athlete, Chinese guy, he had a cyst in his shoulder. He couldn't external rotate with a very, very soft TheraBand, the yellow one. It was the worst condition I ever saw on the shoulder, and he was throwing before he got injured around 78 meters. It's going well for a certain time, but you can prevent if you strengthen your shoulder and especially your back. That's one point. But also work on flexibility. Only strengthen, it's not enough. The shoulder has to be strong, but also flexible. The third thing, what have influences? Surely the technique. As I said before, with using the shoulder too early and upper body too early, so that the arm is compared to the upper body too low under the shoulder axis, on the shoulder, but also on the elbow. Lot of near-edge elbow problems are related to this very low elbow, very low arm.
Okay, fine. So the next question, what is the importance of elbow leading action in release?
Can you tell me again?
What is the importance of elbow leading action in release? In release in javelin throw.
This is
elbow leading action. He's saying elbow leading action.
Elbow leading action in release.
Yeah, the elbow should not lead. He Yeah, like I said in the presentation, it's not with a straight arm. It's a little bit like a baseball throw. Yeah, not so upper body orientated, but a bit sideways from the shoulder and from the head. With the elbow, very important, at least on shoulder level. Better, it's even a little bit over shoulder level. And then the hitting from the forearm.
It's okay, fine, sir. Now the last question: how we can improve inball stride speed? How to improve inball stride speed?
Yeah, that's it's a good question. To improve the speed of the impulse, it's important that you pull with the left leg in front of the body, and actually, as you like to pull the ground under your body. And the right leg, it's getting active forward like a pendulum, you have to we do a lot of impulse runs, for example, where we try to start slow and then accelerate during the run, only with trying to pull from left under your body. That's maybe difficult for the beginner, but very, very important. If you watch videos from Chilesny, for example, or even from older athletes like Miklos Nemeth, you see how active they use the left leg and the right springing leg to get faster at doing the impulse step. We also doing cross step into the sand pit, yeah? To be active and like a long jump, yeah? But sideways, holding the throwing position and trying to improve the length of the impulse. Impulse for male throwers, men, should be over 2 meters, 2 meters 30, 2 meters 40, should be low but long, to have also the time to get in the right throwing position. For girls, 1 meter 80 to 2 meters. That's we are also working, for example, with Anu on. She is losing also at the end too much speed, and cross step it's sometimes only 50 centimeter long, because she has also a little bit wrong rhythm It's all connected.
Okay. That's all. Thank you very much, Mr. Yu Horn, for sharing your depth knowledge, not only experience as a world level thrower, but also as a coach on javelin throw technique, how to start with various lighter implement, and what are the key points to make care while learning and performing with the proper technique. Thank you very much. Now, may I call upon Mr. Walker Herman, High Performance Director, Athletic Federation of India, and also World Athletics Lecturer. Would you please kind enough to say a few words about the today's session?
Yeah, thank you very much, Uwe. I think that was a very comprehensive summary of the major technical aspects of javelin throw. As Uwe pointed out, in the end, it's important that the athletes have a very strong technical and physical foundation, and that it takes time to develop the skills. But we've realized that in India, even at a senior level, we're dealing with a lot of technical difficulties. So the coaches on the ground and the athletes listening to this program, please ensure that you are applying the right techniques from the very first moment, because it's much harder to reteach any kind of technical model in comparison to ensuring decent technical acquisition from the very first beginning. Uwe, once again, thank you very thank you very much. And to all the participants, yeah, please feel free to apply this knowledge. It's not only bound to javelin throw, but whenever you throw a ball against a wall or whatever, ensure that you're following the right mechanics. And of course, in India, we have to differentiate slightly between the cricket ball throw and the javelin throw. And we hope, of course, that we get as much kids from cricket towards athletics in the nearby future. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.